こんにちは、ジャパニーズアモのミサです。Hey guys, today I'm going to teach you how to correctly use the sentence ending particles ね、よ、よね、and け。In the next videos, I'm going to explain how to use な、さ、んだ、and the rest of the ending particles as well.I've already explained some of them in other videos, but I'm going to explain them again. So first, the ne particle is often translated as isn't it or don't you think so? So this particle is used when you want the listener or the person you're talking to agree. So whenever Japanese people see something cute, we would use the word kawaii, right? Kawaii.And when we see something cute, we want to share that feeling of kawaiiness. And we really like to ask the person who we are with, like, kawaii ne, kawaii ne. So that would mean, it's cute, isn't it? Kawaii ne. So you will hear this ne a lot because...More than any nationalities, I think we like it when others agree with us. So we really like to feel the same way as others. So this ne particle is used more than the word isn't it in English. Like in English, if you see something cute, you can just say, oh, it's cute or it's pretty, it's beautiful. You don't always ask, oh, don't you think so? Or it's beautiful, isn't it? But Japanese peopledefinitely use this ne a lot. So kawaii ne, or if we eat something delicious together, we would say oishii ne. If it's really hot, then we would say atsui ne, atsui ne, hot isn't it? Or let's say I'm visiting my hometown with my old friend, like I feel nostalgic and I know that my friend is feeling the same way, I would say natsukashii ne.Natsukashii ne. If I'm visiting my hometown with someone who's never been to my hometown, I wouldn't say natsukashii ne, but I would actually say natsukashii or natsukashii na, which I'm going to explain in a bit. We wouldn't say ne if we don't think that the others can feel the same way. So all my examples have been all informal.So kawaii ne, oishii ne. But you can of course use this ne after this and must. So you can use this ne particle when you have to speak formally as well. So kawaii ne would become kawaii desu ne, kawaii desu ne. So even if you have to speak formally to your boss, for example, you can still say kawaii desu ne. There is also a good phrase, zannen.Zannen, which is used like, oh, that's too bad. So for example, I have an extra ticket for the cinema, for example, and I'm asking my friend, チケットが1枚余計にあるんだけど、一緒に映画見に行かない? And if my friend says, ah, ごめん、ちょっと忙しいんだ, for example, then I could say, ah, 残念, ah, that's too bad.But if my friend is sharing her experience, for example, she bought a plane ticket to Canada, but she got a really bad flu one day before and she couldn't go to Canada after all. Then I want to sympathize. I want to say that I feel bad for her. I would say, 残念だね、残念だね、informally. Or, 残念ですね、残念ですね。Formally. So a lot of learners tend to use the word sumimasen or gomen to mean I'm sorry, as in I feel bad for you. For example, I break my leg. 足の骨が折れちゃった. And you want to say, oh, I'm sorry to hear that. And you say gomen or sumimasen. It sounds like you did something to make my leg break. I would think, did you do something? This gomen, sumimasen.Are only used when you want to apologize. It doesn't mean I'm sorry to hear that, like, or I'm sorry for your loss. Never say gomen or sumimasen because it sounds awful. Anyway, if you want to say I feel bad for you or I'm sorry to hear that, use 残念ですね. Although this is a bit different if someone loses someone. You can't really use this for I'm sorry for your loss because I'm sorry for your loss. You could sayお悔やみ申し上げます。But 残念ですね can be used for most situations except for someone dying. So I couldn't go to Canada because I got a flu. You say, ah, 残念ですね. Like, oh, that's too bad. Or, oh, I'm sorry. And then you say this ね because you are speaking from my perspective. So you're saying, if I were you, I'd feel bad. And then that's how you feel, isn't it? So still, this ね is kind of, you know, seeking agreement.If someone says 残念だね or 残念ですね, a lot of the time people respond to it like 残念 or はい残念です. So here when you're responding to 残念ですね, you don't put ね at the end because you're just saying yes, that is too bad. And this ね can be used like okay, and it would sound pretty nice, you know, instead of sounding like you got it.It's more like, yeah, okay. For example, if you want to say, let's hang out again, we'd say, また遊ぼう。また遊ぼう。また again, 遊ぼう is a conjugated form of 遊ぶ。遊ぼう means let's hang out. また遊ぼう on its own is fine to mean let's hang out again. But you can also add ね at the end, like, また遊ぼうね。Let's hang out again, yeah?Or let's hang out again, okay? And in Japanese, this makes the sentence sound nicer and softer. So it's pretty common to see ne after this let form. So whenever we say let's do something, we often put ne at the end. So 遊ぼうね Let's go to Disneyland next time, okay? We'd say 次はディズニーランドに行こうね次はディズニーランドに行こうね。Or you're going to an all-you-can-eat restaurant and you're like, let's eat a lot, guys. We could also say, たくさん食べようね。たくさん食べようね。You'd also see this ね after the て form. If you don't know what て form is, this is very important, so make sure you learn this form.Te form is also called a request form. So whenever we want to say please do something or do something, it's not exactly an imperative form because it doesn't sound harsh. So instead of sounding like eat, it could sound like eat nicely. So for example, eat, we'd say 食べて、食べて. But we can also add the ね particle at the end and say 食べてね.So eat, okay? And this ne after te is working more to remind someone. So for example, if I have a bag of crisps and say 食べて, like eat, but my friend is not touching it and I think maybe she thinks it's polite not to, so I want to remind her that it's okay. Then I'm gonna say 食べてね, so eat, okay? Or a mom might say 鍵を閉めてね鍵を閉めてね。Lock the door. Okay? If she's leaving the house before the kids and reminding the kids that they need to lock the door when they leave. 鍵を閉めてね。Or if I want to remind the listener that they can ask me anything, okay? I'd say, 何でも聞いてね。何でも聞いてね。And the ne particle can also be used as am I right? So for example, ブラジルは日本から遠いね。ブラジルは日本から遠いね。This sentence can be translated as Brazil is far from Japan. Am I right? So the tone of your voice will be important in this sentence. If I say ブラジルは日本から遠いね。遠いね。So it's not really a question, 遠いね。Then it sounds like it's far, isn't it? So maybe we are on the airplane together. It's like, oh, it's far, isn't it? So I'm not really asking you if I'm right or not. But if I say, 遠いね、遠いね, can you kind of see the difference? 遠いね、it's far, isn't it? 遠いね、it's far, am I right? This usage of ねis not too common. So when we want to say, am I right? We rather actually use yo ne. So the combination of the yo particle and ne particle, which I will explain more in a bit. But basically when we want to say, am I right? we could use ne particle, but we tend to use yo ne more. So instead of toi ne, we might say toi yo ne, toi yo ne. So it's far. Am I right? Before moving on to the yo ne usage, let's see how we use the yo particle in son. You have to be more careful with this yo particle than with the ne particle. Overusing the ne particle, and even if you kind of use the ne particle in the wrong way, it doesn't sound bad, like you didn't offend anyone. Whilst the yo particle, if you randomly use too much, which I've seen a lot of learners do, it can be quite annoying. So this yo particle is used when you give new information. So basically when you tell someone something they didn't know, or at least that's what I assume, because you know, I can be wrong, you might not know, but I assume you don't know, then I'd use yo. For example, I want to say, let's eat okonomiyaki! Okonomiyaki! Tabe yo! Okonomiyaki! Tabe yo! By the way, if I say okonomiyaki tabe yo yo, when you use yo after yo, it sounds like, hey, I got an idea, let's do this! Tabe yo yo! But here, I'll just say, okonomiyaki tabe yo! And you don't know what okonomiyaki is, and you say, okonomiyaki? Nani sore? Like, what's that? Okonomiyaki? Nani sore? And I would say, okonomiyaki shiranai no? Okonomiyaki shiranai no? And then I can say, oishii yo. So I'm telling something that you didn't know. So I say, oishii yo, oishii yo. Here I can't say oishii ne, obviously, because the other person has never even tried it. So they wouldn't be able to agree. So I would have to say, oishii yo. Hey, you don't know, but it's delicious. Or for example, a lot of Japanese people for some reason think that you can't buy cotton buds outside of Japan. It's probably because you don't use cotton buds as often to clean your ears, whilst Japanese people love to do it. Anyway, cotton buds, or some people call it Q-tips, we say menbo, menbo. When I was told that I would have to buy cotton buds in Japan before I go to, for example, England, I wanted to say, no, you can actually buy cotton buds in England too. Then I could say, イギリスでも綿棒が買えるよ. イギリスでも綿棒が買えるよ. So, イギリスで means in England, も means as well. So, in England as well, 綿棒, cotton buds, が Kaeru can buy, and then yo to let the listener know new piece of information. So it's like you don't know, but you can actually buy them. Or for example, you're talking about your favorite American actor, and someone says Idris Elba is my favorite American actor, but you want to say he's actually British. Then you can say Idris Elba wa イギリス人だよ. Idris Elba wa イギリス人だよ. It's like, hey, you didn't know, but he's English. When you use the ne, yo, yo ne in front of verbs or I adjectives, you can just put the particles without adding anything, like kawaii ne, oishii ne. But if you want to put yo ne, yo ne in front of a noun or an adjective, you have to put da in front of the particles. So, イギリス人 is a noun, English person. So, you have to say da there in front of yo. If you want to say, it's a cute cat, isn't it? Then you can say, kawaii neko da ne. Kawaii neko da ne. So, you want to put the ne particle after the word neko, which is a noun. Though there is an adjective kawaii, the thing that you want to put in front of the ne particle is still a noun, so you have to add da in between and say kawaii neko da ne, kawaii neko da ne, it's a cute cat, isn't it? But yeah, anyway, he's actually English. Then you want to say Idris Elba wa イギリス人だよ. So this yo particle is used when you want to tell something new to the listeners. And this yo is also used when you want to give advice, permission, and warnings. For example, my friend wants advice from me. She's like,
どっちのワンピースがいいかな? どっちのワンピースがいいかな?
Which dress do you think I should wear? And if I want to say the red one is better, then I would say
赤いワンピースの方がいいよ。赤いワンピースの方がいいよ。
So 赤いワンピース, red dress, and something の方がいい means something is better. But then I added よ at the end to give her advice, or you can think this as telling something new to her. When you want to say you should do something, we tend to use this form blah blah た方がいいですよ。Blah blah た方がいいですよ。Or without this, if you want to sound more informal, blah blah た方がいいよ。So again, we'd use the よ particle at the end when we want to give advice, like should do something. Like you should hurry, I would say
急いだ方がいいよ。急いだ方がいいよ。
So 急ぐ is the dictionary form to hurry.But 急いだ, you have to put this 急ぐ into its past tense. 急いだ to make the sentence should do something. So 急いだ方がいいよ. You should hurry. Or you should study more.
もっと勉強した方がいいよ. もっと勉強した方がいいよ.
And also when you want to give permission. So when you ask for permission,We use this blah blah てもいいですか form. I've already made a lesson on this. But anyway, for example, if you want to say, May I take a picture? You can say,
写真を撮ってもいいですか写真を撮ってもいいですか
When you are asking for permission, we don't use the your particle. But you want to give permission to the person who asked, can I take a picture? You can say,
いいですよ、いいですよ。
To mean like, sure, go ahead. You can, of course, repeat the word take a picture and say,
写真を撮ってもいいですよ。
But of course, you know, that's a bit too long and repeating the same thing is a bit unnecessary. So you can just say,
いいよ to mean sure
or いいですよ more formally. For example, my friend bumps into me and says, ah, ごめんごめん like, oh, I'm sorry. But you can say 大丈夫だよ like, don't worry. Of course, you can just say 大丈夫 without the よ as well. And よ is also used to warn someone or get attention from the listener. So you'd often hear
危ないよ危ないよ be careful
Banai literally means dangerous, but it's used as be careful. Banai yo. Or when you want to say you can't do something or you are not allowed to do something, we'd say blah blah cha dame. For example, you can't enter or you're not allowed to enter.
Hai cha dame da yo. Hai cha dame da yo.
And also this yo is used to get attention, I said. So for example, if the listener is not really listening, then I say,
ねえ、聞いてよ。ねえ、聞いてよ。
ねえ is also used when we want to get attention, like, hey, ねえ。And then, 聞いてよ, like, listen to me. Hey, listen to me.
ねえ、聞いてよ。
Although, depending on the tone, it can sound harsh or normal. So,
ねえ、聞いてよ, that sounds quite harsh.
Like, hey, listen to me. But if I've got juicy news, I'm like, hey guys, guess what?I can also say,
ねえ聞いてよ、ねえ聞いてよ。
So basically when you guys say, hey, blah, 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 in English, we tend to use your particle. So for example, your friend is like punching you jokingly, but it actually really hurts. And then you want to say, hey, it actually hurts. Then you can say,
痛いよ、痛いよ。
You don't realize, but it hurts. Or,
hey, stop it.
We're saying,
やめてよ、やめてよ。
So yeah, you can use yo after this te form, but if you say blah blah te yo, you could sound like you're a bit desperate. If you want to get someone's phone number, for example, you normally say
電話番号教えて電話番号教えて電話 phone 番号 number 電話番号教えて
tell me.But he said, 電話番号教えてよ! Then you sound a bit desperate. Like,
Hey, please give me your phone number. Of course, this person depends on the situation. So if you are just talking to your close friend and you want the close friend to listen to you, you can also just say, 聞いてよ, like listen to me, or guess what, I've got news. But yeah, you have to be careful with this your particle, because if you say something that the listener already knows but still use your, can sound annoying, and also using too many your can sound like you're better than others. You could end up giving, oh, I know so much more than you vibe. Yeah, and you can definitely use your if you're saying something that the listener doesn't know, but for example, if it's not really interesting, it's not very good. For example, if I tell you guys that I'm actually 50, which is not true, you'd be kind of shocked. Or I hope you'd be. If I say, 50歳だよ, then it's kind of interesting. Like, hey, you didn't know, but I'm actually 50, 50歳だよ. But for example, if I say something that you guys already know, so for example, if I say, 日本人だよ, it's nothing new, so it's kind of hard to react. So it's like, oh, okay, like we already knew, but okay. Or if I say, Pikachu が大好きだよ, then that's like, okay, we already knew that. So don't use your if you don't think it's interesting enough, or you know that the other people know. So for example, as a part of the conversation, you have to say, Canada is bigger than Japan, but there are more Japanese people. I'm not trying to impress the listener. I'm just saying as a part of the story, right? So it's not like, hey, you guys don't know, but Canada is actually bigger than Japan. It's not like that. It's just like, the fact is that Canada is bigger than Japan, but there are more Japanese people. And here, if you, for example, say, Canada は日本より大きいよ, right? Then it sounds like, I think you guys don't know that Canada is bigger than Japan. Yeah, it sounds like you're trying to sound so smart, so people might not like that you use よ. It's like, yeah, we know it, or like, it's not even your main point, and you're trying to show off that you know that. So yeah, you can be quite dangerous in a way, but you can be used nicely as well. So for example, if I'm acting insecure, I'm saying, oh, I'm not cute at all, people hate me, right? And then my friend wants to say, that's not true, you're cute. Then she could say, kawaii yo, kawaii yo. You don't realize, but you are actually cute. So that usage is quite nice. Or this example is basically the same, but like, I don't think this looks good on me, for example, and say, ah, これ似合わない, これ似合わない. But if you think this looks good on me, for example, then you can say, 似合ってるよ, 似合ってるよ. What are you talking about? It looks good on you. So now we know that ne is used when you seek agreement, and yo is used when you tell something new, or give advice, or to get attention, right?But when you combine them together, よね, I briefly explained around the beginning of this lesson, but it can mean, am I right? So this is used to make sure if what I said is right. So when people say よね, they think they are right, but they just want the confirmation. So it's not like they have no clue, but they just want you to say, yeah, that's right. So for example,I think you told me that you have a younger sister, but I can't be 100% sure. Then I want to say, you have a younger sister, right? Then here I would say, 妹がいるよね。妹がいるよね。So I think you have a sister, but I want to just make sure, you know, just in case. Then I would say, 妹がいるよね。This is completely different from just saying,妹がいる? Or 妹がいますか? As a question, like, do you have a sister? Then it can be a bit annoying to the listener if the listener already told me that they do. So it's like, you forgot that? Whilst よね is like, I remember it, but I just want to be sure. So again, よね can be used with this. So you say, 妹さんの名前は夏子ちゃんですよね?
妹さんの名前は夏子ちゃんですよね。So your sister's name is 夏子, right? Here, if you say 妹さんの名前は夏子ですか? It sounds actually a bit creepy because I'm like a psychic where I just can't tell your sister's name or I just can't tell what your sister's name is. Although if, for example, I'm in your house and I see a notebook that has someone's name on it and I could say 妹の名前は夏子 and it could mean there's a name that I don't recognize and it's in your house so obviously it must be your mom or sister and I could say is your sister's name 夏子 then I can say 妹の名前は夏子 informally or 妹さんの名前は夏子さんですか but if you've told me already what her name isAnd I want to make sure that I'm right, then I'd say 夏子だよね or 夏子ですよね Or again, you told me that you like Batman, for example, but I'm not too sure if it was Batman or Superman, I can't remember, but I want to say you like Batman, right? Then I'd say Batman が好きだよね Batman が好きだよねFormally, Batman が好きですよね? Here, if I ask Batman が好きだよね? And you want to say, yeah, you can just say, as yeah, or hi, as yes, right? But you can also say, そうだよ, yeah, that's right, or そうですよ. So you can here answer with the your particle to mean, yeah, that's right.Yeah, so whenever I want to make sure I remember what you said correctly, then I would say, よね? If I want to say, you said blah blah blah, right? I can say, blah blah blah, って言ったよね? Blah blah blah, って言ったよね? So I've already made a lesson on this, って言った said, so you want to check it out if you haven't seen it. But instead of, you like Batman, right?Like, Batman が好きだよね? I could also say, you said you like Batman, right? So then I can say, Batman が好きだって言ったよね? Batman が好きだって言ったよね? But this よね can also be used when you want to suck up to someone. So I've already made a lesson on how to use そうです、そうですね、そうですよ、そうですよね。In that lesson, I also explained that そうですよね sounds like yeah, that's right, I agree when you're trying to win someone's approval or you know, you really want to be polite to that person and saying it. So I said sucking up to someone and people do use it that way, but it's not always like that. Basically, you use this よねwhen you want to express that you really, really agree. So instead of just かわいいね, cute isn't it? If I say かわいいよね, then that's stronger than かわいいね. So it's like, it's cute isn't it? I want you to really agree. かわいいよね. But it's not just me wanting you to agree, but also ifSomeone just says kawaii and if I really agree, I can say kawaii yo ne. Yeah, you're so right, it's so cute. So if senpai says kono fuku dasai, this outfit looks so lame, right? For example, kono fuku dasai. Dasai is slang and means lame or uncool. Kono fuku dasai. And you know, if I want my senpai to like me, I would say, oh, dasai desu yo ne. Orそうですよね。Yeah, you're absolutely right. But sometimes you want to tell something new, but don't want to sound snobby. Then we actually use this blah blah んだよね。Blah blah んだよね。So for example, I want to say, oh, this restaurant is expensive, but it's not like you askedIf it's expensive or not, maybe you didn't even show interest in this restaurant. Then I would say, このレストラン高いんだよね。このレストラン高いんだよね。Then this doesn't sound like I'm directly telling you something you didn't know. It's just something you don't know, but it's not that you have to know sort of thing. So it makes it sound softer. It's more like me casually saying, you know, something new. Doesn't matter if the listener would find it interesting or not. If I'm talking about cinema, for example, I say, 昨日映画館で映画を見たんだ。This and that is used when you want the listener to have interest and I want the listener to listen to me. Then I'll say that at the end. 映画館で映画を見たんだ。My friend could ask, どこの映画館で見たの?どこの映画館で見たの? And if I would say, in Aeon. Aeon で見た。Aeon で見た。Then that means I saw it in the Aeon. Aeon is just like a shopping mall in Japan.Yeah, Aeon で見た. But I want to kind of just continue the conversation by saying their popcorn tastes great. For example, that information might not benefit my friend. My friend didn't even ask about the popcorn, but I just want to say, あそこのポップコーン美味しいんだよね. あそこのポップコーン美味しいんだよね. So that's me telling my friend something new.So my friend's never been to that cinema and I want to tell her why I went to that one. So I could of course say, あそこのポップコーン美味しいよ if I think she's kind of interested in that. But if I just say, 美味しいんだよね then that's me explaining why I went to that cinema without making it a big deal. So this usage, you need this んだAnd that is used when you want to explain something or when you want the listener to have interest in what I'm going to talk about. So at the beginning I said yone can be used like am I right? And I said you'd use that when you are quite sure but cannot be fully sure. So 誕生日は3月だよね。Your birthday is in March, right? And I'm like, I know it's March but I just want to be sure. Whilst ifI want to sound more like, I just can't remember, like, am I right? There is another way to do this. We would put ke at the end. Ke. So if I say, 誕生日は3月だっけ?誕生日は3月だっけ? It sounds like I can't remember it. Obviously, I remember well enough that I say 3月.But maybe I could be really wrong. So 3月だっけ? So this け is actually used very often. When you can't remember something, we put this け at the end. It could also be used like, remind me. For example, what did I eat yesterday? Like, I can't remember what I ate. Then I'd say, 昨日何食べたっけ? 昨日何食べたっけ? So 昨日何食べた?means what did I or what did you eat? But if I put ke at the end, it's like what did I eat yesterday? It could also mean what did you eat yesterday? Depends on the context. Like you just told me, but I can't remember. Then it could mean what did you eat yesterday? I can't remember. Remind me what you ate. Or if I can't remember someone's name, I would say, ah, 名前なんだっけ?名前なんだっけ? What was this person's name?So you can only use yone if you have a clue what it is. So if you do remember that person's name, but you are not fully sure, but you think that person is called Suzuki-san, then you can say, Suzuki-san desu yo ne? You are Suzuki, am I right? Whilst if you don't remember anything, and you're saying, oh, I can't remember, then you'd put this ke.So I can of course do Suzuki-san desu ke? Like, you Suzuki-san? I can't remember. But if I want to say what was his name, I can't remember at all. I would have to use this ke instead of yone. Because yone can only be used if I'm more certain about that person's name. So nandakke is like, what was it?This is a very common phrase. なんだっけ? What was it? Can't remember. Or we went to this restaurant 3 years ago, but you can't remember if it was good or not. Then I'd say, このレストラン美味しかったっけ? このレストラン美味しかったっけ? So I can't remember if it was good or not. Remind me. Was 美味しかったよね? Sounds like
I'm pretty sure it was good. Am I right? So there is a difference. But this ke is also very, very common. So you should remember it. So whenever you want to say, when was it? Who was it? What was it? Where was it? You can use this ke. So, なんだっけ?お、なんでしたっけ?誰だったっけ?誰でしたっけ?お、いつだったっけ?いつでしたっけ?どこだったっけ?どこでしたっけ? Alright, in the next lesson, I'm going to explain how to use んだ、の、な、and さ. So, we still have quite a few ending particles.But yeah, we'll cover them. Alright, thank you for watching. じゃあまたね。バイバイ。